So there's a lot of conversations going on in the country on how we can have industrialization rampantly done to not only create jobs, but also encourage more people to produce to, you know, match the balance sheet of export volumes in this country versus imports is what I'm talking about. So there's a recent model that was launched that, if implemented, the brains behind it say could help Uganda, you know, spur its industrialization agenda, which the president constantly talks about. And, you know, the dream is to have more industries, create more jobs for Uganda so we can stop importing more and start exporting as well, so we can create some money. It's a conversation that we await to see. Plus, the recent conversation around URA and traders' threat to protest were the taxes. And finally, somehow, you know, there was an agreement that was reached for now to let the traders operate and shops remain open. That's after they had wanted the shops closed. We can only wait to see how the new financial year will start and what will prevail in the business space and across the region. There's so much as well happening. But for now, welcome to the Business Show. My name is Simon. This is what's coming up on the show this week.
First and foremost, you can do this if you believe in yourself. But as I said, you have to put in the work. So you're young, you've just come out of school, maybe you're looking to set up a business. Start where you are.
Once again, welcome to the show. Now, there's so much happening across the world of business, but this week we'll start with SMEs and how we can grow them. We know for a fact that they contribute about, what, 90% of businesses in Uganda, yes, and 75% of private sector in the country as well is owned by these businesses. However, the struggle still stays on. Most of them try so much to win the clients and also grow their sales on a single day, or a daily, you would say. After COVID, most of them have struggled, but the goal remains clear: to have your clients retained. Plus, if you can also grow the customer base without necessarily meeting these people, but putting all these things online, then it is something that you should be embracing. This week on Views from the Top, I speak to Alpha Kenyatta from PesaPal, who talks to us about using tech to enhance customer experience of SMEs. And we are hoping that through this, probably the SMEs can increase their sales, but also create more customer base across. This is Views from the Top.
My name is Kenyatta Alpha. I take care of the retail and e-commerce business at PesaPal Uganda.
Okay.
I'm glad to be here and to share with you some insights in as far as payment technology is concerned.
Good stuff, and thank you for making time indeed and speaking to the Business Show. Let's start the conversation with how technology is transforming customer experiences in the financial services industry.
So technology has greatly transformed customer experience in a sense that customers can now make payments from wherever they are, through different payment options like mobile applications, like internet banking, contactless payments at the comfort of their homes. So technology has brought things like speed, security, and accuracy when processing payments. Yes.
All right, good stuff. Let's talk about then how PesaPal, well, you know, the organization that you work for, is utilizing technology to improve customer experiences, but also generally streamline payment processes.
So at PesaPal, what we've done is that we've built solutions that are customer-centric. So we have a couple of solutions that range from the on-site payment solutions and the online payment solutions. So just to break it down, I'll start with the on-site payment solutions. So we've built on-site payments. We have our PesaPal Sabi, commonly known as a Visa machine, PDQ terminal, or a point of sale machine. Yeah, for customers who don't have cash but have Visa, MasterCard, and mobile money to be able to make payments to the business. On the other side, we've gone ahead to build e-commerce solutions for businesses that sell goods online. Could be via the website, could be via social media or any other online platform. So we've built e-commerce gateways or payment gateways that enable customers to pay for goods and services from wherever they are. And they support cards as well as mobile money.
Okay.
So that said, one of the things that really make us stand out is that we are the only payment service provider that has the capability of providing both on-site and online solutions at the same time. Yes.
Amazing stuff. And you know, I've been following your story for close to 10 years now.
Yes.
This is an industry that has so many players. What do you think has kept you unique and still competitive?
Yes. In my opinion, I would say we have been customer-centric. Yeah. So we listen to our customers, get to understand their pain points, and then give them solutions that solve their problems. So that is one thing that really makes us stand out. And then the other critical thing is support. You see, payment solutions always have a lot of issues, yeah, technology-wise and many others. So as PesaPal, we are always there to ensure that we support our customers 24/7. Yes, so via different channels, like we have a business team that goes out in the market to ensure that the customers are well taken care of, they're well trained, and in case of any challenges, they can always be addressed with the business team. Away from that, we have our merchant support team that now works remotely and can be able to handle customer issues even past working hours.
Okay.
So in my opinion, I think that support and being customer-centric are the two things that have really made us stand out in the market.
Okay, let's talk about some of the things you have done to enhance security and trust for customers.
So speaking about security, we've deployed a cyber source system that helps us in monitoring now all transactions that are done across all platforms. And then in case there are any suspicious transactions, the system can be able to flag them, and then we can proactively now intervene to do checks and ensure that fraud is mitigated. Then the other thing, we've made sure that we are compliant with our regulators. We've gotten the licenses that are required for us to run business in the country with the safest security protocols. Then from that, we've gone ahead to implement other security protocols like PCI DSS certifications, PCI PTS certifications. Maybe just to speak a little bit about those security protocols. PCI DSS stands for Payment Card Industry Data Security Standard,
okay,
which ensures that customer information transacted online is secure and cannot be decrypted. And then the PTS protocol ensures that now whenever you are transacting at any terminal for PesaPal, you have to approve or authorize a transaction with a PIN. So meaning that there are no instances where you will have to run a transaction without a PIN.
Okay, that's good stuff. Let's talk about how you're working with other platforms to create a seamless and convenient payment experience for customers.
So speaking about collaboration, we've worked with a couple of players in the market, including the telcos like Airtel and MTN, where we have now integrated those payment options on our PDQ to enable customers now pay through Visa, MasterCard and mobile money. So that helps businesses now to collect more cheaply and conveniently.
So looking ahead with the trends that we see now,
yes.
My question would be, what do you think needs to be done, or what are you doing as PesaPal to stay afloat of whatever would happen in this space now?
So looking at our trends, I see new innovations coming on board, like contactless payments, like artificial intelligence, and many other things. So what we've done as PesaPal to prepare for the future, we've been able now to implement contactless payments on our payment solution, specifically the PDQ or the point of sale. So a customer can walk in with a contactless card or even a digital wallet, say Samsung Pay, Google Pay, Fitbit Pay, and actually complete a payment. So you can be rest assured that we are working closely with the trends and doing a lot of research to ensure that we build an ecosystem that meets our customers' expectations.
Okay, yes. As we come to the end of this conversation, let's talk about what needs to be done to encourage more people to embrace a cashless economy.
We as payment service providers and other key industry players, we have to collaborate and educate our customers that they can pay securely through digital payment options. And then on the other side of things, I would like to encourage now all business owners to benchmark on technology to be able to process secure payments in their businesses and reduce on the risks of having cash and associated disadvantages like fraud and many others.
So there's no doubt, it's definitely clear that if you're going to keep in the space of technology, then you must match the pace with which innovations continue to come through. Almost every single day as you go to sleep, some other guys are creating something new to match the competition. So as a business person, if you adopt a particular, let's say, app to help you, you know, increase your sales, you don't sit back and say, now I am comfortable here, I am making money. Yes, you could be making money, but keep up with the developments and the innovations in the space, because every other day there's something new that is happening to help you grow your business. We hope all these conversations can help you spur your business and also make the money, the more reason you wake up every single day. Yeah? So there you have it, views from the top this week. Time now for a quick break on the program with me, Simon. When I get back, I'll be telling you about how passion drives a doctor into cake making. I'll see you shortly.